Yes. Rolling sound, quiet.
Wait.
Good day, good world, and welcome to Subgenre, a podcast about the movies. I'm your host, Josh Dasal, and in this podcast, we talk about films outside the major categories, and in season one, that means the often nail-biting, always fascinating subgenre of submarine movies. In this episode, we're gabbing about a World War II-era classic from 1958. It's an undersea actioner starring the mustachioed gentlemanliness of Clark Gable and the square-jawed ferocity of Burt Lancaster. Directed by The Sound of Music's Robert Wise, we're talking Run Silent, Run Deep. And with me today to break things down is our guest host. He is a fellow director and screenwriter, he of the Oscar-nominated short film Johnny Flinton, and the Justin Lin feature film Better Luck Tomorrow, and frankly, just a genuinely wonderful human being. It's Fabian Marquez. Hello, Fabian.
Hello, Josh. Thank you for that fantastic intro.
You are welcome. Well-deserved. And let me just say, I am very, very happy to be doing this show with you. I have wanted to do something with you for a very long time, and I'm very happy that it's this.
Oh, same here. I think this is long in the making, and I hope it's the first of many more.
Me also. And I have to ask, because I think I probably ask you when I ask you to do the show, but how do you feel about submarine films? Are you a submarine film guy, or is this kind of a new thing to you?
You know, the opportunity to do this with you pretty much forced me to confront the fact that I love submarine movies. I've always loved them. I just never really put myself in a category as like, you know, I'm a submarine film lover, but you know, this exercise has made me completely come to terms with that fact. And frankly, I'm more than okay with it.
The fact that you love submarine films really just proves that you're human, and I'm happy to know that.
Well, there was some doubt at some point, but my humanity now is not in question.
Well, now that we got two human beings talking about submarine films, let's talk just a little bit about this film, about Run Silent, Run Deep, and what do we know about it?
So I had never seen this film, and thanks to you, this gave me an opportunity to check it out. For those who don't know, well, as you set up briefly earlier, this is a World War II movie. It's from 1958. It takes place almost exclusively on a submarine called the Nurka, which is a fantastic name. It's got a little bit of Moby Dick. It's got a little bit of Mutiny on the Bounty to it. And it's just a super cool addition to the submarine subgenre. Part of that is because of its street cred. It was adapted from a novel written by a real-life submarine commander, Edward L. Beach. He drew inspiration for the book from his own experiences serving on two submarines during World War II before taking command of his own sub, the USS Piper, before
the nuclear sub. A nuclear sub. That's how cool he was.
Right. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So he was, you know, he's basically an overachiever. And then after that, he became a New York Times best-selling author, of course, as one does after, you know, doing all of that in World War II.
Yeah.
He's only 25, you know, or 26 by the time he's doing this. But the movie, you know, because of its... It was a huge success. It was a bestseller, and it got the A-list treatment from Hollywood. As you mentioned, cast-wise, it has a fantastic cast. Clark Gable, Burt Lancaster, Jack Warden, and Don Rickles in his feature film debut.
His first movie, Mr. Warmth in his first movie.
And he is warm in this. He's all smiles, although you do get a little bit of that edge, that Rickles edge coming through.
Absolutely. And let's not forget the fact that when this movie premiered, and I think it was like in April of 58, it premiered not on Hollywood Boulevard, not at Man's Chinese, not in New York. It premiered on a submarine in the Atlantic Ocean. You know, I think it was off the coast of California, but I had all these, you know, all the stars I would imagine in the tuxedos heading down into a submarine to watch the show.
How do you do that? How do you get, how many people can you fit into a submarine? How do you put a movie screen in a submarine?
It's a wonderful question. I'm sure if we have any submariners listening, they're going to let me know. But I think that that gets us to the right time to be talking about our feature presentation. So our feature presentation, obviously, is Run Silent, Run Deep. Run Silent, Run Deep is a submarine film that really focuses around this story of a U.S. sub commander who is just obsessed with sinking this Japanese ship that had blown up his previous one. And to be able to do that, he's got to butt heads with a first officer who really isn't thrilled about that prospect. So it's 1942. Commander Rich Richardson, who is played by Clark Gable, is the former sub-captain. The Akikaze is the name of the Japanese ship that had blown him up in a place called...
The Bungo Straits.
The Bungo Straits, which if there was ever a wonderful place for there to be, I don't know, sub-battles and old folks' home, the Bungo Straits sounds like it.
It's what I want to name my kids, Bungo Straits. Or a band?
I think it's a band. I think we should start a band. It's Bungo Straits. So you've got Rich Richardson, basically a desk jockey now. He's assigned to a desk in Pearl Harbor. He spends most of his time playing out this same battle, or maybe a better version of this battle, with the fake ships on his desktop, usually helped out by actor Jack Warden playing Yeoman First Class. Is it Mueller? Mueller? I think it's Mueller. Mueller on the brain from 2020, but I think it's Mueller.
It's Mueller.
Yeah, he's there pushing around ships. And Mueller just happens to mention, you know, if you were looking to captain another ship, there's this boat called the Nurka that's coming into port, doesn't have a captain, and, you know, you might think about that. And Clark Gable's thumbs up about it.
Yep. He's like, well, tell me more.
but who is not thumbs up about it is the XO, soon-to-be captain, or at least he thinks so, of the Nurka, Lieutenant Jim Bledsoe, played by Burt Lancaster.
Burt Lancaster.
Absolutely. And joined, of course, as we mentioned, by Don Rickles, who is, like the rest of the crew, so excited that that the XO is going to become their captain.
It's a great scene. They throw him like, it's almost like a birthday party. It's like they kind of do a little bit of misdirection and then they reveal that he's got his special like captain's jacket. And it's like a really great, you know, celebratory moment. And then
comes what I like to refer to as the powdered milk moment, which is the commander? It was fleet commander or something. I'm not sure I figured out who the guy was, but the boss shows up and says, you know, Jim, let's talk over here in the kitchen on the ship. And we'll make some powdered milk while we talk about this. And I tell you that you're not getting command. And instead it's going to go to the guy who asked me 5 minutes ago.
Nothing like a stiff glass of milk to help the bad news go down.
Yeah, that's what I have. It's what I'm having right now. I'm having a stiff glass of milk.
It was the most 50s by way of 40s way to handle this. You know, he literally asked him, do you have milk? And this is as they pass the picture of the pinup that they have up on the wall. And he kind of embarrassingly has to tell him like, oh, the guys put this up and we pat her for good luck as we go by. And he's like, where's my milk?
So we pat the pin up on the behind, we grab a glass of milk, and we find out that Clark Gable will be serving as captain when this ship goes back out, not you, Lieutenant Jim Bledsoe.
Yes.
Yes. So doesn't go over well. Bledsoe's not happy, confronts Richardson at his home, but ultimately it is what it is. And so we're in our first days at sea. Richardson is announcing orders to the crew. It ends up that they are not going on a pleasure cruise, that they are actually going to what is called Area 7, not a good neighborhood.
Right.
But he points out, not the Bungo Straits. Not the worst part of the bad neighborhood.
Yes, he's steering away from that dangerous thing that we as an audience just know he's never going to go back to.
See, he's not going back there. He got sunk before, right? Wink, 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 wink. So Rich gets the crew working hard. He says, hey, we're gonna spend all of our time not doing the normal stuff that you guys are used to doing. We're going to start practicing this one particular drill. And it's kind of an interesting one, isn't it?
It's oddly specific.
Yeah.
It's all about timing. It's about diving with getting the dive down to 32 seconds.
32 seconds.
Popping the periscope down, you know, later than they normally would. And the whole crew is a little bit flummoxed by the strangeness of these drills that he keeps hammering at.
That's because, I mean, they're playing chicken. That's basically the drill, right? It's find a destroyer and play chicken with it.
Yep.
So we find a destroyer that definitely isn't the Akakaze or a stand-in for it. We get it to turn towards us. Definitely not what we want the Akakaze to do later when we definitely don't meet it. And then we figure out how to do that in the fastest way possible.